So children, we are here starting with the structural organization in animal chapter 7. So first of all, here they have written was I was telling you, if the organism is unicellular, then it performs all its body function by the single cell. But if it is made up of many cell, like in Hydra, it is made up of thousands of cells, so the body functions are performed by many cell. And if it is a human body whose body is made up of billions of cell, so that the body functions are performed by billions of cell. But these in multicellular animals, a group of similar cells along with the intracellular substances perform a specific function such as organization is called as tissue. That means the group of cell performing the same function, same origin, they are actually form a tissue. Now these tissues actually group together to form the organs, and organs then forms the organ system like digestive system, respiratory system and all, and then all group together to form a body or a individual. So this is the level of organization as I have discussed you in previous video. Now it comes the animal tissue. Types of animal tissue are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissue as they have written here. Now they are here starting with the epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue, as in this book they have all given in paragraph, and these four diagrams are there. And after that, this page is also there, and now it is completed here, and this is little bit some different topic. Okay, but I have converted the whole topic into the form of notes, and this if you will understand through the notes, then the things will be clear to you in the book also. Now first of all, we are here taking up the characteristics of epithelial tissue. Okay, before that we are to here see that tissues are actually what we have already seen, that tissues are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissue. Out of that we are taking the epithelial tissue. So first of all, the characteristics of epithelial tissue, just a minute, we are to start from here. First of all, I have written the definition of tissue, which I was showing you here. The same definition I have copied it here. Then the types of animal tissue, which I was showing you here. And after that, the epithelial tissue. Now, epithelial tissue is of two types, simple epithelial tissue and compound epithelial tissue. Simple means made up of single layer of cells, and compound means made up of many layers of cells. Now, this simple epithelial tissue is again of many types, squamous, cuboidal, columnar, cuboidal ciliated, columnar ciliated and glandular. This all we are to discuss in detail on the next pages that I am going to start now. Now we are here starting with the, just a minute, we are here starting with the characteristics of epithelial tissue. So these are, as I told you, they form the surface either outer side or inner side. If they are facing the outer side, then they will face the environment. Inner side, they will face the body fluid. And they are commonly called as epithelium. And they forms the covering lining of the body organ. Suppose this is a body organ, so its outer cover is also made up of epithelial tissue. And inner cover is also made up of epithelial tissue. And it is made up of compactly arranged cells with very less intracellular matrix, and the cells lies on the basement membrane. Now simple epithelial tissue, as it is written at the back also, it is made up of single layer of cells, and it forms the lining of body cavities, ducts and the tubes. Ducts means tube only. And the compound epithelial tissue, it is made up of two or more layers, and it is protective in function. It will come again in detail. Now the third is special epithelial tissue. So this is A, B and C. Now we are taking one after the other. A. A is simple epithelial tissue. As it is written, simple epithelial tissue is made up of single layer of cells, and it is further divided on the basis of the shape of the cells. Shape of the cell is structural modification. So first type of epithelial tissue, as it is written here at the back in this list, that is squamous epithelial cuboidal. So squamous epithelial tissue, the cells are flat, they are more broader than longer. In one diagram I have labeled, in all other you are to imagine the same. Only the shape of the cell will change. Flat cells, nucleus, cytoplasm and all cells lies on basement membrane. The most important part is that for every tissue various examples are there. And question will be like this, that in this part of the body, what type of tissue is present? Hence, I have underlined them with the red ink, that this squamous epithelial tissue is present. It makes the walls of the blood vessel and air sacs of the lungs, that is called as alveoli, and its function is diffusion. As I told you in previous video, ki wherever it present, it change its function. So it is present in alveoli, so it will help in the process of diffusion. Now it comes the cuboidal epithelial tissue. The cells are cube-like, that means equal in length and breadth. It is written here single layer, so obviously because simple epithelial tissue is there. And it is present in the ducts of the glands and tubular parts of the nephron. Nephron, you know, it is a kidney tubule. Okay. Now it comes the function. Because it is present in the nephron, so its function will be absorption. It is present in the gland, so its function will be secretion. Now it comes the columnar epithelial tissue. These cells are more taller than broader and these cells are column-like, so that this is called as columnar epithelial tissue. And nucleus is there at the base. It is lying on the basement membrane. Sometimes these columnar cells possess microvilli also. It further divides and redivides to form microvilli. This is here it is written. Now example of columnar epithelial tissue. It forms the lining of the stomach and intestine. And its function is secretion. Because it present in stomach, it will secrete some enzymes. And it is microvilli are present in intestine, so its function will be absorption in the intestine. Now it comes ciliated epithelial tissue. Sometimes this cuboidal and columnar epithelial tissue possess cilia at their free surface, then they are called as cuboidal ciliated or columnar ciliated epithelial tissue. Okay, and they are present on the, that is the more inner surface of the hollow organs like bronchioles and the fallopian tubes. And wherever they present, because they are having cilia, so they help in the movement of the particle or mucus in the specific direction. Now it comes the glandular epithelial tissue. Again, it is a modification of cuboidal and columnar epithelial tissue only. Sometimes they get modified to form the glands. Now these glands and their function is secretion. Always glands function is secretion. These glands on the basis of number of cell can be unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular gland is example is goblet glands or goblet cells. They are present in the alimentary canal. One cuboidal cell has got modified to form a gland. Multicellular glands like salivary gland, they are formed by a cluster of cells. Example is salivary gland. Now on the basis of presence of duct, they are further divided as exocrine glands and endocrine glands. If duct is present, then they are called as ductful glands like mucus glands, salivary gland, mammary gland, earwax gland, oil gland, etc. And if duct is not there, then they are called as endocrine glands like thyroid gland, pituitary gland, parathyroid gland and all those. Okay, so this is about the all type of epithelial tissue. Now it comes the compound or complex permanent tissue. Now complex permanent tissue is of made up of many types of cells. Here it is written. Compound or complex permanent tissue, it is a stratified epithelial tissue also called as. It is made up of many layers of cells. Okay, and its main function is to protect from mechanical stresses or chemical stresses. Now it is further divided as stratified keratinized, stratified non-keratinized. Sometime at the, it is cuboidal at the base and then gradually it becomes squamous and then these cells become more flattened and ultimately they become dead due to the deposition of a protein called keratin protein. So they become dry and डेड ऑल्सो एंड दे कवर द ड्राई सर्फेस ऑफ द स्किन. तो स्ट्रेटिफाइड केराटिनाइज्ड एपिथेलियल टिश्यू इज प्रेजेंट इन अवर स्किन. समटाइम दे डू नॉट गेट डेड एंड दे रिमेन सॉफ्ट अगेन एंड दे आर अलाइव ऑल्सो, दे आर लिविंग एंड सो दैट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रेटिफाइड नॉन केराटिनाइज्ड एपिथेलियल टिश्यू विच इज प्रेजेंट इन बकल कैविटी, इन फेरिंग्स, in inner lining of salivary gland and in pancreatic duct. So this is about the compound epithelial tissue. Now the last comes the third one, that is C. C was the special epithelial tissue. In that the most important one is the pseudostratified epithelial tissue. Pseudo means false and stratified means compound. So it appears to be compound epithelium. It appears to be multi-layered, but actually it is single-layered. Here you can see the length of the cell is differing. Some of the cells are small in size, some other are tall in size, so that it appears that there are two different layers of cell, but all these cells are lying on the basement membrane, so they are single layer only. Hence it appears to be multi-layered, but actually it is single layer, so that it is called as pseudostratified epithelial tissue, and it is again present in the salivary gland and in trachea, okay, respiratory system. Now another important tissue special is transitional epithelial tissue. Wherever the contraction and relaxation is required, like in urinary bladder and in ureter, the transitional epithelial tissue is present because it is stretchable because of the different layers of cell. In the lower layer, the single layer cuboidal cells are present. In the middle layer, 2-3 layers polygonal pear-shaped cells are present. And in the top superficial layer, the large broad rectangular oval cells are present. So because of these various layer, it becomes stretchable. So it is present in those organs where do the stretching, contraction and relaxation is required. So that it is called as transitional epithelial tissue. So this is about the types of epithelial tissue. So this you can do it from your book or from the notes only. In notes each and everything is written very systematically. Now it comes the last paragraph of epithelial tissue. That these epithelial cells will join together or get adjust with each other with three type of junctions. Tight junction, adhering junction and gap junction. Tight junction are very tight. They stop the substance leaking across. They do not allow the movement of the molecule. And adhering junction, they are perform cementing or neighboring. They are called as desmosomes also. And they are little bit movement of molecule can take place through the adhering junction. But in gap junction, there is a gap between the two cells and the cytoplasm is also present. So that means intercellular material is also present between two cells and it allows the movement of the molecule from the cytoplasm of one cell to the other cell. So that they are called as gap junction. So there are specialized junctions are present between the cell which are here categorized as tight junction, adhering junction and gap junction. This is multicellular gland, this is unicellular gland, this is compound epithelial tissue they have shown here. I have drawn the simple diagram in notes and here they have shown the squamous, cuboidal, columnar, column-like cells are there and ciliated columnar epithelial tissue. So that way these are the diagram which are given in your book. This is all about today's topic. Thank you.